Makes sense.
So like just like the time you got to put in, so that, you know, it can be very difficult. But I did that for about 2 years, and then we kind of began to like pivot to like run our own things. It's kind of,
I feel that, man. Change of motion.
Yeah.
It'd be like that. I mean, I feel like Charlotte was in my, like when I was young, I was always wanting to go to other cities. I was always wanting, like my brothers were out in Cali or they were in New York.
Right.
And when I would go visit them, I'm like, yeah, I need to move to one of those places because I can't do what I want to do if I'm not there.
Yeah.
And as I got older, I started to realize like that wasn't always the case.
Right.
Yeah, I mean, there's opportunities, but out there, it's just like you're just competing with so many other different,
right?
You know, people that are also trying to do the same thing.
Exactly.
So it can be also kind of like challenging at the same time.
Exactly.
Yeah. So more a like, you know what I mean? A hybrid model.
Right.
The barbershop in conjunction with like selling apparel, shoes, and Gabriel's solely just like reselling shoes or. Yeah. Basically like high-end, like, you know, streetwear fashion.
That's what I was thinking too.
So I think they somewhat connect, but then some are, he'll probably have a different, like, you know, insight or perspective. Both of them may have a different perspective on like how they, you know, started, and also like their thought process, you know. So I think it's good just to kind of like have like both, so we kind of can see.
That quality looking nice, boy. but yeah, we in the process of like trying to make our dream come true. You know what I'm saying? Like, this stuff ain't no joke. Fashion being relatively available to them, but when you look in small cities like this, where it's growing and there's potential for it, but nothing's happening. You know?
Yeah.
What I'm
saying? No, absolutely, man. I think, kind of piggybacking off of that, you know, we think both discovered that there's like a need for a space that not only from like a fashion standpoint, but just from like a communal standpoint, where you can like come gather, you know, like socialize, build community, especially for people that are creatives. You know, I think that, you know, spaces like that can really like breathe and provide some type of synergy around like create, you know, in that. I think that it does kind of get to a point where you're like, dang, man, like, it gets daunting, you know, to think about, like, the cost and, like, you know, how you're going to, like, pay your bills and everything that comes along with that, you know?
Exactly.
I think that's also a part of, like, the process to embrace.
Right.
Is, like, you know, recognizing, like, the why. Like, why is it that we're, like, looking to, like, create this, you know, vision for the city of Greensboro, which is, you know, kind of like you said, like a smaller city,
right?
But there's so much potential within, you know, a city like Greensboro to really have something stick and really like be something that people can look at and be like, hey, like this is like actually home, you know what I mean?
Because
like so many people come in and out of Greensboro, it's like a transient neighborhood, considering like
exactly
people come here for school because it's cheap, you know, or people come here because like, you know, it's just a nice, like, they have like NC State, so it's
cool,
a predominantly, you know, like black school that's been around for over 100 years, and they really enjoy that aspect of it. But what would it look like for someone to actually like either remain in the city of Greensboro or actually just like embrace the other aspects of the city, you know, outside of like the colleges and universities that pretty much make up
the,
you
know, entire city,
you know what I mean? So
exactly,
just trying to provide like a different flavor, you know, just to provide like another space and an outlet for folks to come in, chill, look at the store. Even if they come in, don't even buy anything.
Yeah.
At least they have a space.
They can
come
do
in
something.
And like, you know, just do something different, you know, that they haven't done before. And I mean, like, this, like, just from my background, like living in California, living in New York, you know, and now, you know, living out here in Greensboro.
Right.
I think that's something I really embrace, just like that, like, community, you know, to like really just like find that. And I mean, you can find it, you know, pretty much anywhere. How cool would it be to have, like, an actual boutique store that incorporates and cultivates, like, that type of, you know, energy together, you know what I mean?
Thinking of a name is, like, the hardest part.
Yeah. It can be hard, I mean, because,
like, we could just be like, okay, F it, like, name generator.
Right.
You know.
Just, like, create a name for us.
Yeah. Name generator.
Flash a wand and there you go.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? I think it's going to come to us. I think that the more we kind of continue to reach out to folks that have already, like, started their own brand or boutique, and then I think eventually once we capture our story behind the brand, mm-hmm. it's going to come to us, yo.
Right.
You know what I mean? And it's just going to be, oh, dang. That's it right there.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, that's it. So,
that's you.
You know? Get some inspo from me. What happened to those other shirts?
Which ones?
Some more. I knew we were missing some.
All right, so I'm currently in the car with all the gear, as you can see here. Clothes hanging up on my racks. So we have arrived. I don't know if you can see me in the mirror.
Probably can't.
Maybe I have to turn this up a little bit. There you go.
Do we want to, like, ask to do it, like, on, like, a Sunday? Because then that way we can do it, like, for, like, the whole day since it's not open. Yeah. Or we want to do it, like, on a Saturday, but I'm sure, like, a Sunday may work better for both parties. But I don't know. I guess we can kind of ask and see.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Okay. Yeah, I think Sunday would work, too.
Let me move his banana.
Yeah. All right.
Got banana peels everywhere.
Like I used to, though.
All right.
Oh, man.
What it do, baby?
Hey. bars or
down that way.
How you feeling?
I'm feeling blessed and highly favored.
Yeah, amen, amen. Dang, man. How you feeling?
Feeling much better now. Got something to eat, y'all. I was starving.
Dude, I was so hungry, B.
I'm not doing that to myself anymore.
No, we can't be sacrificing like food and like
for my overall well-being.
Yeah, for some thrifted goods, yo.
Right.
those 40 cents
are
just gonna stay right there.
Yep.
I just want to say thank you for all my fans for always showing me support. It's always amazing just to see how you guys always show out. I mean, like, I'm just lost for words, speechless. Thank you, God. Sorry, guys. I have a couple of things on my shirt. Let me just make sure I'm looking right. But yes, like, it's been amazing. Wait. What? I hope you're not recording this.
It is.
That's hilarious.
She just recorded me getting my...
What the... The cameraman is on the camera. You know what I'm saying? Well, I ain't got really much to say besides...
Nobody asked.
Oh, okay.
I'm just kidding.
My heart.
I'm just
Jesus.
Kidding.
Okay, after, you know, the heartbreak just now that we witnessed, this has, like, been a blessing. This whole experience has been incredible, to say the least. It feels interesting to be in front of the camera, like, after recording this entire trip. I think it's in the process of the little steamer. It's in the process of like boiling out all the excess water. What do you think?
Huh?
Do you think the steamer is boiling? It was going crazy in the beginning because of all the excess water. Or?
Bro, I have no clue, but it's working because that's all that really matters to me.
Right.
Shoot.
For real. We're waiting for Travis Scott to drop some crazy stuff, yo.
You guys can certainly follow us. Check out the teaser as well, y'all. We just put it out this week. Shout out to everyone who also just like showed mad love, you know, thanking us.
Yeah.
Or
for
not
sure.
Thanking us, but just, you know, showing mad love, y'all.
Yeah, if you haven't followed us yet, definitely go to our social media page. We have our Instagram, we have our Twitter, and we also have our Facebook. I'll show you our Instagram. So you see our social media right here. It says Nostalgia. Boom. So you definitely go follow us. You know what I'm saying? We're in the process of growing and everything. And as you can see, 70 of my followers follow the page. That's good. But I need like all 700 of them to be following this. Or at least like 500. There's no reason why you guys shouldn't be following. that this is our like little teaser trailer. You know what I'm saying? So definitely go follow that if you want. We also have our Twitter as well. So here's our Twitter page. You know what I'm saying? Follow us there. How you feeling about tomorrow's shoot?
I'm feeling amazing, y'all. This is going to be our third shoot. Scouted the location out a few days ago. It's going to have like an industrial kind of feel. So,
yes.
Got some creative things that are going to happen on this shoot. And, yeah, I'm excited.
Dope.
Definitely excited.
Yeah.
Good right there. Hold that.
This feels weird.
You said it feels weird?
Well, I don't know what to do with my hands.
Oh, no, your hands are good right there. Oh,
okay.
Yeah.
I'm gonna
look forward.
Huh?
Were you smiling? I was kind of smiling.
Oh, no, I wasn't.
Okay. No smiling.
Okay. Little smile.
Okay, you can look. So you, Jessica, can look. Kind of, yeah, that's good. You said no smile. Okay, you can rest.
Smile. I said little smile.
Like I'm back in New York.
Process of don't mind my hoodie, it's just a little small. I'm sitting here using like a white hoodie and we're our hands dirty. I'm in the process of making the crates for you people. Nah, not you people, you guys that help us and support us. We're in the process of making the crates that will be the displays for the TVs that we have, which will be in our first pop-up.
How you feeling, Ryan?
I'm tired.
He said, I'm tired.
We're here though, you guys.
Yeah.
Building these crates. This is where the real work gets put in, yo.
We got the gloves on and everything, yo. Keep the Lowe's way.
Woo.
Yes, sir.
In the Lowe's.
Never we meet it. Never. Sheesh! This song go crazy.
Fresh off vacation. Yo. Like 3 a.m. in Atlanta. Yo. Hey. Jesus is King dropped, and I got a few messages saying Jesus is King sound like a Swoop record. Comparison's cool, yes, but I count it a true blessing that we got a new messenger, but not a new message. I'm praying for Kanye, I'm grateful that God saves. I'm praying for y'all placing limits on God's grace. Remember when God came and got you about your grave? I bet then you did not complain or question that devout change.
Yes, sir.
We're done.
Yo, listen, y'all, it's 1:31 in the morning. We just wrapped up just some BTS stuff, and then really just trying to get some things, you know, kind of organized for the upcoming pop-up we have. I'm not gonna lie, I'm tired, but I'm also excited at the same time, because like it's really about to like go down.
It's not gonna pop off. Yeah,
like we've been literally like planning and just like on the move for the past like almost like 2 months, yo. And really we didn't have like a game plan besides like, yo, like let's just like go run with what we got and just put our time and effort in, and this is the work that, you know, we've put in. This is what, you know, basically it's all come to. So
let's get it, man.
You know, we here, man.
Hope y'all ready.
Hope y'all ready for this, y'all. Y'all not gonna be pump faking.
We gotta bust the block down. The whole block gotta be burnt out. This nut.
Your boy's out though.
We need to be forgiven. Yes, sir. We need the
gospel. Yes. All right, man.
We need our
God to bless.
See you,
we need our God to protect all of his children, including Kanye Omari West.